अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द मल्टीपल प्रेगनेंसीज आर द मल्टीपल गेस्टेशन। मल्टीपल गेस्टेशन इज डिफाइंड एज द नियरली साइमल्टेनियस बर्थ ऑफ मोर देन वन बेबी बाई ए मदर। द फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ द मल्टीपल गेस्टेशन हैज इंक्रीज ओवर द ईयर्स एंड दैट इज ड्यू टू द रीसेंट एडवांसेस regarding the ovulation and the IVF, both are labeled as the assisted reproductive techniques. In case of induced ovulation, where the problem with the female is the related to the ovulation problem, the exogenous androgens are given to the females to induce the ovulation, and that may result in the ovulation of the more than one oocyte. And the other is the IVF. In that case, the chances have of the multiple gestation have increased many folds, and the frequency has raised over 3% of all the live birth in the United States for during the last years. The multiple gestation may be twins, triplets, and so on. Continue. So, twin pregnancy is the nearly simultaneous birth of the two babies by one mother at a time, and it is of two types. That is the dizygotic twins, which accounts for 2/3 of the twin pregnancies, and that is development of the two babies from two separate zygotes, and the monozygotic twins, which accounts for 1/3 of the total twin pregnancies, is the development of the two babies or more even from single zygote. Dizygotic twins, which are also called the fraternal twins, are the womb mates. As in this type of the twin pregnancy, there is a fertilization of the two ova by two separate sperms. So, the developing babies may be of the same or the opposite sex, and they are identical to one another, like the brothers and the sister of that family. They usually implant separately. So they have two placenta and two chorions and two amnions, meaning they have their own membranes. Sometimes chorions are so close to each other they get fused. So the developing babies have fused chorions and the fused placenta, and occasionally each dizygotic twins possesses red blood cells of the two different types in this case, and that is called the erythrocyte mosaicism. The dizygotic twins shows hereditary tendency, as the frequency of the twin pregnancies in the family which have earlier twin pregnancy has many times more than the ordinary families, and that is shows that they have the hereditary tendency, and it is also different in different races. That is, it is more in European as compared to the Asians, and also even more in the Africans if you compare even with the white people. Dizygotic twinning also increases with the maternal age. With the passing increasing age of the mothers, the chances of the giving rise to more than one baby increase. Dizygotic twins causes, I have already told you, hereditary, ethnic, racial, white, more, and even the black people even more than the white and the Asians have less. Chances of the zygotic twins is more in tall, older, multiparous and females belonging to the upper class. They have more chances. As in this case, the two ova are fertilized by two separate sperms, so they implant at two different sites, so they have their own chorion, own amnion and own placenta. Sorry. The other type is the monozygotic twins. They are the true twins, also called the identical twins, as in this case there is a fertilization of the one ova with one sperm, so they will be of the same sex. As they are developing from one zygote, so they will also have the same genetic makeup and resembles each other in genetic composition as well as in most of the time physical resemblance 100% almost. Yes, that the development later on may have some differences, but usually they are resemble to one another physically also. Usually the twinning begins in the blastocyst stage. That is the end of the first week, and that result from the division of the embryoblast into two primordia. As they share this one blastocyst cavity, so they will have one chorion, but they will develop their own amnion. So they will be labeled as monochorionic and diamniotic twins. They will have the one chorion, that is the one chorion, and one placenta shared by the both babies, but they will have their own separate. This blue lining is the lining of the amnion. So they will have their own amniotic cavity, but the chorionic cavity is the same as is the placenta. Already told you that most of the monozygotic twins from the splitting of the inner cell mass during the last days of the first week, and that accounts for almost 65% of the monozygotic twins, and this the B1. In this case the inner cell mass divides into two groups, so they have two separate babies, but as they share the blastocyst single cavity, later on they will also share the single chorionic cavity, but they will have their own amniotic cavity. But the single placenta and the single chorionic cavity. In 35% of the cases, the separating is too much early, usually at the two cell stage, so it is the separation of the blastomeres. The two cell resulting from the division of the zygote, they get separated, and so they will form their own blastocyst cavity. So definitely due to that they will have their own chorionic cavity, so they will be attached at two different sides, so it will be like the dizygotic twins sometime. And the rarest one, which is also shows the high mortality due to the sharing of the amniotic cavity as well, and that variant of the monozygotic twins from the separating during the last days of the second week, that is just appearing before appearing of the primitive stage, and at that stage the separation sometimes is not complete 100%, so result is the conjoined twins. And if not conjoined twins, as they are very close to each other does not get 100% separation, so they will have their own syrup, does not have their own amniotic cavity or the chorionic cavity, rather they have a common chorionic as well as the common amniotic cavity and a single placenta as well. Again, the variants of the monozygotic twins and their time of the separation. The most common is the early embryoblast stage, in which they have a single chorion but two amnions, and the second most common is the splitting as early as in the blastomy stage, sometime even in the two cell stage, and that is the late bilaminar stage, and in that case they will have a common chorion as well as a common amniotic cavity, and that variety shows the many male formations, so have a high mortality rate. Complications of the monozygotic twins is the intrauterine growth retardation, fetal distress, premature labor, small at birth, and high mortality, especially in case of monozygotes, in which they have a single amniotic cavity and a single chorionic cavity. Now the congenital anomalies related to the twin pregnancy. The twin defects, which are called, number one is the vanishing twins. It is the death of the one embryo or even the one fetus in the very early. So it is the death of the fetus during the first or the early part of the second trimester, and that results from resumption or mummification, and that is called the fetus papyraceus. The dying baby is sometimes so small that even it is difficult to recognize that the female have two. Then is the twin transfusion syndrome, also called the fetal transfusion syndrome, and that results from the unequal distribution of the placental blood flow between the fetuses, or there is a epidovenous male anastomosis, and that results in the shunting of the arterial blood from one baby to the venous system of the other baby. It is the shunting of the blood from the arterial system of the one baby to the venous system. So from arterial to venous system, and that usually occurs in the 10 to 15 cases of the monochorionic diamniotic monozygotic twins. Complications are too much as the donor fetus is small and anemic, as most of its arterial blood is going to the venous system of the other, while the recipient fetus will be large and polycythemic, and that will cause the congestive heart failure. So one die short of the number of the blood cells, and other die from the excess number of the blood cells. And the treatment of these is the fetoscopic laser coagulation of the arterioanastomosis. So the both babies can be saved by this treatment. Another is the conjoined twin, also called the Siamese twins. The name is given from the name of the Thailand, Siami, a region in the recent Thailand country, where the twins, conjoined twins, were produced, and they were shifted later on to the America, where they remain many years. It occurs in monozygotic twins, and the variant in which there is a separation of the amblyblast in the second week, giving rise to the monochorionic, monoamniotic, monozygotic twins, and that is called by the incomplete splitting of the amblyblast in the region of the primitive node and the primitive stem, that is at the start of the formation of the trilaminar embryonic disc nucleus. It results from the fusion of the adjacent discs. Sometimes it may be very simple, as the only there is a skin bridge between the two babies, but sometimes they may be joined, even some organs are common, for example is the liver, and they are named according to the body region involved. If the thoracic region is involved, they are called the thoracopagus. If the cranial region is, they have joined in the region of the cranial, so they are called the craniopagus and pyopagus if the lumbosacral region have a joint status. Sometimes they have only two separate heads, but they have a common body, so only two upper limbs, two lower limbs, single trunk, but the head are two, and they are called the dicephalus. This concludes the lecture on the multiple gestations. We will meet inshallah with another topic in a few days later. Thank you so much.